Hi, my name is Puraskar Sadani. I'm the editor for Elite Magazine India, and I welcome you all on a hunt to find India's 25 most influential and dynamic entrepreneurs. Today, we are going to be having a conversation with a young entrepreneur who started his journey as a doctor and ventured into entrepreneurship at the age of 24. So let's go and have a wonderful conversation with Ritesh Malik of Innovate. So today I'm with a doctor who started his entrepreneurial journey in 2013 at the age of 24 and is today one of the most dynamic entrepreneurs I have met. So yeah, we have Ritesh with us. Hi Ritesh Malik, how are you?
Good.
So yes, I believe from doctor to entrepreneur, you've had quite an interesting journey in the last 5 years.
Very diverse, yes.
How come from a doctor to an entrepreneur? What was the...
So Indians suffer from a disease called APS, Asian Parent Syndrome. So both my parents are doctors and they said that you have to become a doctor. And I hail from a small Punjabi family where you're not allowed to do anything which your family doesn't allow. So I had to become a doctor, but post that I took that risk and started my entrepreneurial journey.
Wow, so I remember, I think if I'm not mistaken, you started with an app in 2013 for augmented reality, and then, you know, in 2013 itself, you had the opportunity to sell it, amazingly, to a big, huge company. Wow.
So we started an augmented reality platform, and it was finally on a build, operate, transfer model given to Times of India. And that was a very interesting, in those 8-9 months, really helped me understand what entrepreneurship is all about and gave me that confidence that you can and do something in apart from healthcare.
But that's so amazing. I mean, I've yet to meet such entrepreneurs, you know, have the confidence, A, from, you know, going against, I should not say against, but, you know, still going on their own. I know, because at times with parents and pressure, you at times give up. And plus, you've already, you know, done your medical and everything, you've become a doctor. And then also you're saying, okay, fine, I'm going to keep this aside, all these years of studying, and then going into entrepreneurship, taking that risk. And then coming out and shining so bright. Now do your parents trust you now with your entrepreneurship?
They're very happy now.
So yeah, so all the parents out there, you should trust your children, you know. It's great. I mean, at times, it might not be the right path that you might think of. But yes, today, with so much of innovation happening all around the world, sometimes they can surprise you. And with innovative minds like Ritesh and everybody out there, you should give them that little bit of an edge and say, okay, fine, you know, give it a shot. So yeah, so you started with the app Alive, right?
Yes.
Which is now with Time. So after that, you went into Innovate.
Yes.
So a lot of people who don't know about Innovate, they have about 3 lakh square foot right now, and they're all over India, and they're a co-working space.
Yes.
Why don't you tell me a little bit of that?
So one thing which we realized in India, which was missing, was the fact that entrepreneurs did not have physical real estate spaces where they could come share their ideas, meet like-minded people and create products for the nation. So we thought that let's create one small all center. It was our first one, Connaught Place. And with the four principles of location, design, community and technology, we started the first one. And we realized within 20 days, we were bubbling with people. And we realized that Indians have so much talent, and we thought that theek hai, now what we do is we will create these spaces, larger spaces span India. So as we speak today, we have 13 campuses with 4,000 entrepreneurs, freelancers, small and medium businesses working out of our facilities. And the idea is that we aren't an office space for them. We are their entire support system. The focus is that you do your work and we will help you build your community, your networks, your everything is outsourced to Innovate, and you just focus on your product.
Wow, so you're giving so many entrepreneurs the right opportunities to expand, to let all these tiny, tiny issues. I remember when I started my own entrepreneurial journey, I think the first few months it was all about setting up the basic needs, basic office setup, basic on. And if I think today, if somebody was there to help me minus all those, tensions, which I could say, and also investment. You know, I remember it used to be a big investment to investing into a new office, investing into furniture, air conditioning, so many things.
Agreed.
So if somebody gave me a turnkey thing that time, you know, why don't you come here? It's a pre-established space.
Yes.
You can occupy it and start working from tomorrow onwards.
Yes.
So that is something very innovative. So why don't we continue this conversation over tea?
Yes.
Come. So we have TWGT as our partners for India's 25 most influential entrepreneurs. We have, I think, the world's finest teas here. What would you like to have, sir? We have Silver Moon, we have French Earl Grey.
I'll have a Silver Moon.
Silver Moon?
Yes.
So great. So yeah, we were discussing about Innovate as a place. You also are funding quite a lot of new startups, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah. So with this mission called Project Gorilla, our vision is that Indian entrepreneurs have so many good ideas and they just need 5, 10, 20 lakh rupees of capital to actually experiment with those ideas. And we thought that, okay, let's create a platform where anyone can come build their product with a very small seed capital of 10 to 20 lakh rupees and just give them a platform where they can just try out their idea, because failing is also a very, very important thing when it comes to entrepreneurship. If you don't fail, you'll never be able to innovate. So with Project Gorilla, we've done over 41 startups so far. We have successes like Josh Talks, which is India's largest inspirational content and platform. We've done startups like Wittyfeed, which is Alexa rank 11, and it was, I think, a month back, Alexa rank 11, more popular than Instagram and tier 2, tier 3 cities of India. We've done startups like Asimov Robotics, which...
Yeah, I was talking about robotics. You're really going ahead with a lot of new robotic companies. I think that's the future way.
Yes.
Let's have some tea, sit down, and take this conversation forward. So you funded 41 companies, that's quite a big number. You told me about robotics, content generators, what other than that?
So when it comes to companies is how we are very sector agnostic. We do not care what sort of a sector the entrepreneur is in, but our idea is that we focus on the product wisdom of that particular founder. We have done a tea company, we have done an organic face blends company. So it's anything which can generate revenue and is made in India. So the idea is that if you see Facebook, 35% of our works of the workforce of Facebook is Indians. But when it comes to India, we do not have our own innate nation-backed social networking website. If you see Google, 32% of Google's workforce is Indian origin. We have some of the finest minds in the world, but we do not use them for our own product generation. And if you see, India will become when you talk about population, we will surpass the population of China by 2028. And the country will be in a condition of civil war if we do not generate employment. And the idea is that these kind of companies, technology-led companies, consumer-led companies, is we need to build our own factories. We need to make sure that we can and sustain the employment in demand in the next one decade. So for that, with Project Gorilla, our focus is don't worry about how the money will come back, but worry about what quality of product are we generating out of national soil. So with this, we have over 100 founders in our network in which we have invested. And luckily so far, we are doing very well with the capital that we have deployed. And in terms of the scale of impact that we've done on some insanely amazing companies, like I mentioned, Wittyfeed, Josh Talks. We've done Asia's largest crowdfunding platform called Keto, which has raised millions of dollars for Kerala victims, Nepal earthquake, and a lot of not-for-profit organizations as well.
Wow, that's quite a lot. And I don't think there's any other entrepreneur today in the country who's doing so much for young entrepreneurs. And I think it was driven by your own struggle, your own, was it a completely different reason you thought, you know, you need to help more entrepreneurs?
So I think we need to build India into an entrepreneurial machine, because we will not be able to generate employment if we do not.
And totally agree, and completely.
And apart from that, I think as a country, our education system is very backward. We haven't changed our education system for the past 250 years. I still remember I was slapped by my teacher for not knowing when was Babur born. I always question that. I do not need to know when was Babur born. I need to understand why did Babur do what he did. And I think...
And what are the lessons we learn out of his... So that's the most important thing, not the year. I agree on that.
On top of that, our education. So I had a very candid conversation with an Israeli teacher. There's a nation called Israel, which which personally has inspired me a lot. If you see their condition, they are at war for so many years, but still they are the epitome when it comes to technology, security, startups, when it comes to agriculture. A nation which does not have water supply is still one of the pioneers in agriculture. So I just asked them that, how did you do this? How did you create a force of entrepreneurs out of Israel? And she said that the reason is twofold. One is our education system is very, very pro practicalism. So what happens in Israel is from the age of 10, fifth class, they have a subject called entrepreneurship. They have a side subject which teaches people what is innovation all about. And the second one is their focus on career counseling. We do not have career counseling. I went to my principal and I said, I do not want to become a doctor. And he said, are you mad? Dude, your father sees 50 patients a day, you will see 100 patients a day, and your child will see 150 patients a day. See the kind of growth generation on generation you are generating for your family. I said, dude, I do not want to become a doctor. This is a personal. So I think like fingerprints are different, brain prints are different. You might be passionate about something which I might not be. So I think getting people and work is such an important part of our lives. After doing Innovate, I realized we have 4,000 customers, each customer spending almost 8 to 10 hours a day with us. That's almost 36,000 hours as man hours spent at Innovate every single day. And that's like 1.2 million man hours every month. And I realized that if a person is not happy in what he does, he will never be able to
never succeed. That's
by and large, Indians are garbage. We hate Mondays. we drift from Mondays through Fridays.
And we love Fridays.
So I think this needs to change. People need to love what they do. And with Innovate, our focus is that offices should not be mundane. They should be beautifully designed. It should be an experience to
its own self. I don't like Sundays at all. I feel out of place. I'm like, what do I do today? So, and that's, I think with entrepreneurship that comes, that, you know, that the drive that you have within you, you know, it just never stops. The drive never gets a Sunday.
And a very interesting thing which has lately started happening is that entrepreneurship is not about people who find or who actually start companies. Entrepreneurial skill can also be in an employee. Just about how you deal with work. It's how you express yourself. There has been a drastic shift from people who... So there was a survey conducted by this startup called Youth Ki Awaaz. And in that survey, a very interesting thing came out that people have stopped working for salaries. They really want to work. For missions that are very close to their heart. So I think if a perfect blend of work-life balance would be to actually do something which you are mad about. A lot of people ask me, ke aap bahut baatein karte ho, passion aur insert ki. How do you know that this child is passionate or not? So I had a good answer to that. I said, the problem with our teachers is that they go to the first page of copy and they see what's written. Passion always comes to the last page. When teacher...
wonderfully said.
So last page...
Agreed.
When the child is making a plane, he wants to become a pilot. I still remember I used to make a lot of buildings. I was mad about entrepreneurship in real estate. So I think wahan pe hai na, our education system is not able to ignite that thought.
That fire, yeah.
We just have very four professions in our country.
Doctor, engineer,
and a CA. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, if someone wants to become a poet, they say, are you mad?
Poetry kya karo? That's there. But it's so nice. And I think for us, for 25 of India's most influential entrepreneurs, there could be no bit better than you to start our journey and our search. So we are glad to have you with Elite. And yes, we are that learn even more. For all the people who want to know more about Ritesh and his company and his ideas, you should get the next issue of Elite magazine and read about his journey, his passion. And yes, we'd love to see you on the 6th of October for our 25 Most Influential Entrepreneurs event. And also to young entrepreneurs who are watching this, how should they get your kind of inspiration? I'm sure there are a lot of startups which are looking for funding, who are looking for the right kind of people to support them. How should they get in touch with you?
My email ID is pretty simple. It's info@drriteshmalik.com. So I get almost 100 mails a day here. And you'll be amazed to know the kind of mails that I get. A person, yesterday itself I got a mail from a very small village in Tamil Nadu called Tindigul, वहाँ पे एक लड़के ने सोलर एनर्जी का एक पूरा मॉड्यूल बनाया विच इज 3 times मोर एफिशिएंट देन द कन्वेंशनल मॉड्यूल्स. सो आई थिंक इंडिया में जितना पोटेंशियल है वो किसी देश में नहीं.
And Dindigul has amazing biryani. Huh? We were there a few months.
My village from where I've done my MBBS is just half an hour from Dindigul, so that is why.
So we were there in Chennai to review a biryani company, which is 60 year old, and they have 50 outlets all around the world. And they got their name because the recipe comes from Dindigul, and the grandfather who actually sat at the counter wore a turban, which was in their language called Thalapakatti. And there was Anand Villas, they were named Anand Villas, but in 1972 they changed their name to Dindigul Thalapakatti because of public choice. So again, that's also a scene of entrepreneurship.
Yes.
So yes, wonderful meeting you, Teji. It was it was a pleasure, and looking forward to learn a lot of more things from you. This is Pushkar Pradhani from Elite Magazine India, and see you soon.